Welcome class 5. Today we will do force, work and energy. Okay, in our science class. So it is not actually clear to you. It is force, work and energy. Okay, so it is force, work and energy. Now we know any force we can define by push or pull. Anything, if we are just holding, we are catching any ball, if the ball is coming towards us, that is a, we are pulling our hand towards us. When we are just making anything disperse, or just anything is just being keep from one place to another, either pushing is needed or pulling is needed. So energy can be defined by pushing or pulling. See, here are a few pictures are given here. You see the pictures are very clear to you, because in this picture you see a horse is pulling a horse is just drawing one or dragging one cart. So how this horse is dragging the cart? As the horse is pulling the cart towards it, the cart is moving. In another section you see the boy is just trying to take the water or drawing the water from the well. So how is drawing the water from the well? As the boy is along with the rope, he is pulling the rope towards it, so the water is coming out. In the last scene you see the person who is just pushing pushing a wheelchair, so that is also a work is done. So either we have to apply push or we have to apply pull so that we can do our work. So any kind of work, what kind of force is needed? Pulling or pushing force is needed. Now here it is, to move anything we can pull or push. When we play cricket, we push the ball with the bat. During cycling, we push the pedal of the cycle to move it. To open a door, we either push it, we have to push the door, or we have to pull the door to open it or to close it. Now, some other examples of push and pull are shown here in the picture. So, I have shown you there. And the next, effects of the force. So, force always does not move an object. For example, when we apply force on a wall, it does not move. So, when we are applying, suppose it is a block of a wood and we are pushing this, that means this force we will apply on it and it will move to this part. But if we will draw it back, then we have to apply the force, we have to pull towards us, then this block will come to us. Okay, so near to us. So there will be either we have to push or pull to if a object we want to move, for the movement of the object we have to apply the force, push or pull. But if I suppose I am pushing this board, is it the board is moving? No, the board will not move. So the object which are having the more force, or the they have the more strength than us, we cannot move them, because we have to move the only we can move the object if we will apply the force more than its strength, then only the object we can move, or we can just move away, or we can pull it towards us. So the movement of the object depends on the on that object's strength as well as our pushing or pulling force. Okay, now effect of the force, we can see there are different kinds of forces which work on different way. Force can stop a moving object. So if we'll throw a ball, suppose we are throwing a ball, a person is catching this ball, so that person must be, what kind of force it is? So you see the person try to move the ball like this, isn't it? So it is a pulling force towards it which make to catch the ball. And in the same way you see this ball is actually was going towards this direction, and when we stop it, we have to apply the force in its opposite direction. So when we are stopping it, when we are just stopping the ball, and at first we will apply it, that time we can stop. So through our hands we are applying the opposite force to stop the ball. Okay, now when we apply a force on moving object in the opposite direction, the moving object either becomes slow or it will become stopped. Just like in a when you are swinging swings, that time at first you apply you straighten your legs, and the force become more in the swing, and you become more forceful in the swinging, and these swings will go in a high. But when you want to stop it, that time in opposite direction you try to move your legs towards the inside, or you move your legs towards inside in the opposite direction, and then the swing will become slowly, it will become at first it will become slow, and then ultimately it will become stop. So in the opposite direction when we are applying some force, then we can stop the movement of anything. Next, force can move a stationary object. Suppose a ball is here or a chalk is here. If I just throw it, what will happen? It will move. So it will just it is an stationary. So anything which is being kept here, a ball, a chalk, it is being kept here. And when we'll kicking it, suppose I kick it, then it will move. And it will move and it will cover a distance. So for the movement of any object, we have to apply the push, or we have to kick the ball. That means we are applying the pushing force. Okay, and the force can change the direction of a moving object. Suppose when we play the badminton, shuttlecock comes to us and we apply the force, and the shuttlecock goes in different direction. So we can move the direction of a moving object by applying the force. And even we have seen in the cricket also, ball comes towards the batsman and batsman just hit that. Sometimes it goes straight, sometimes in another direction. So we can just change the direction of any object, moving object, by applying force. Okay, so force can change the direction of any kind of object. Now force can change the shape of an object. Suppose we are having a empty plastic bottle. If we apply the force, we can deshape it. We can just crumble it, crunch it, and we can just deshape it. And even when we just roll on a rolling pin, when we play in a rolling pin, and we try to take a dough of atta or flour, we can make it spherical in shape, we can make in any shape, we can change. So by applying force, we can change the shape of any object, isn't it? Suppose you are having some spongy things, we try to squeeze it and it becomes so very little and it occupies very little place, and then when we just release the force, it comes to the natural shape. So the force is there which we can use to change the shape of any object. Okay, now what else? Now there is a type of forces. We have to come to know what type of forces are there. So if we talk about the type of the forces, there are, at first we will do it, first MCQ. First question is, a push or a pull of an object is called a push or pull of object is called, what it should be called? It should be called force. It is a force, isn't it? So force is the correct answer. Second one is, to move an object we need, again number two, to move a object we need, what we need, C against C, that is force. So both in the multiple choice question, in both cases there will be force. Now types of forces, there are types of forces. Number one is magnetic force. Magnetic force. Number two, electrostatic. Electrostatic. Number three, gravity, or you can say gravitational force. And number four, and the last one is, that is buoyant. Buoyant force, and the fifth force is frictional force. Friction force. So there are so many kinds of forces. We can see, first one is magnetic, second electrostatic, third gravitational force, fourth is buoyant force, and fifth one is the fifth one is actually frictional force. So one by one we will cover it. What is magnetic force? We know, when you bring a magnet near to any iron or the nickel object or cobalt object, magnet have tendency to attract them. It is a force that attract the iron nails toward itself. Now second one is the electrostatic force. When we comb our hair and keep the comb in front of bits of paper, they will attract them. Third one is the gravitational force. Anything is falling down from any higher places, they come down on the earth surface. That is the gravitational force. We know earth has a gravity. It has a center of gravity, so everything is being attracted by it. Third one is the buoyant force. When we try to draw anything, ball in the water or anything, then we can feel a up thrust or upcoming force is there, which is pushing it towards the another direction. So that is the buoyant force. And last one is the friction force. Any object, when the surface is any kind of surface, when it is rough and applying the force opposite to its movement, opposite to the force of the movement, then that is the frictional force. In my next class, I will just explain all of you. Okay, so that's all for the day, and you please do your